Hola chicos, ¿cómo están? Bienvenidos a otra clase de inglés. El día de hoy vamos a aprender acerca del pasado simple. Welcome to other class. Today we will learn about the simple past. Okay? So, we use the simple past to talk about events in a definitive time in the past. Recordemos que usamos el pasado simple para hablar acerca de eventos que han ocurrido en un tiempo definitivo en el pasado. Entonces, vamos a ver las tres formas: la afirmativa, la negativa y la interrogativa. The affirmative form. We have first the pronoun. Primero tenemos los pronombres o el pronombre. Next is the verb in past. Seguido del verbo en pasado. And next is the complement. And don't forget the period final. ¿Ok? Entonces tenemos el pronombre, el verbo en pasado, el complemento y el punto siempre al final. Good. I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they, scan, a photo. Very good. Next, in negative form, we have the pronouns. Next, we have the auxiliary did and not. In contraction, didn't. And next is the verb, the base form of the verb. And the final, we have the complement. En la forma negativa, primero vemos a los pronombres seguidos del auxiliar did, que nos representa el tiempo pasado. Pero como es una forma negativa, entonces está seguido del not. La forma completa es did not, pero si queremos usar contraction podemos usar didn't. Después nos damos cuenta que el verbo está en su forma base y que no ha sido transformado a otra forma como en el caso del afirmativo. ¿Okay? Vamos a recordar esta regla, por favor, seguido del complemento. En la forma interrogativa vemos first the auxiliary, next the pronoun. Next is the base form of the verb, and it's the complement, and the final, we have the mark question. En la forma interrogativa vemos que primero está el auxiliar, seguido del pronombre y seguido de la base, forma del verbo, del complemento y el signo de interrogación. Cuando nosotros hablamos de la forma negativa e interrogativa, nos damos cuenta que el verbo no cambia, aun cuando sea en la tercera persona. Entonces, esto es más sencillo. You can do it. If you want to ask this question, si quieres responder esta pregunta, in affirmative form, yes, en una forma afirmativa, es yes, I did. If your answer is negative, this is no, I didn't. Okay? Remember, please, this. Recuerden que en la respuesta de forma pequeña no podemos hacer contraction, pero en la respuesta pequeña en forma negativa es posible. Good. So, the verbs for simple past are regular and irregular verbs. Vamos a ver algunos verbos que algunos son parte de los verbos regulares y algunos son parte de los verbos irregulares. Okay? So, I have some examples here. Tengo algunos ejemplos aquí. For example, for most verbs, add ed. Para la mayoría de los verbos, agregamos la ed. Sería invent, invented. Okay, next. For verbs that end in E, add only D. Para los verbos que terminan en la letra E, solo añadimos la D. Arrive, arrive. Okay, very good. Next. For verbs that end in a consonant plus Y, omit the Y and add I, E, D. Para los verbos que terminan en una consonante y una Y al final, omitimos la letra Y y en vez de ella ponemos IED. Study, studied. Very good. Next. For verbs that end in a stress vowel plus consonant, double the consonant. Okay? Para los verbos que terminan en una vocal y una consonante, duplicamos la última consonante y agregamos la ED. For example, scan, scan. Refer, referred. Okay? Good. Esas son las reglas para poder usarlas con los verbos regulares. ¿Pero qué pasa con los verbos irregulares? More common irregular verbs are be, was, or were. It depends of the pronoun. En este caso, si ustedes se dan cuenta, en la mayoría de verbos hay algunas letras que suelen cambiar. Esto es porque ellos son verbos irregulares. Entonces, del verbo to be, su pasado es was or were. Depende de los pronombres. Begin, began. Break, broke. Build, built. Buy, bought. Come, came. Do, did. Drink, drunk. Drive, drove. Eat, ate. Find, found. Forget, forgot. Get, got. Go, went. Have, had. Hear, heard. Learn, learnt, or learn. Make, made. Read, read. Run, run. Sing, sung. Speak, spoke. Tell, told. Write, wrote. ¿Ok? Entonces hemos practicado la pronunciación de estos verbos y espero que puedan hacerlo en sus casas. Remember, practicing is the key of your successful. ¿Ok? La práctica es la clave para el éxito. Next, to practice these different topics and different verbs, we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 exercises to practice this. The first, read the sentences below, circle the regular verbs, and underline the regular verbs. Okay? So, circle the regular verbs. Okay? This. And underline the regular verbs. This side. Good. A. When I passed my exams, my parents gave me a 21-inch smart TV. Ooh, that's good. What is the regular verb? Passed. What is the regular? Gave. Very good. Next, I played a lot of video games when I was younger. They were addictive. Okay, what is the irregular verb? Yes, was, and where. And the regular verb is played. Good. Next, I didn't have a cell phone until I was 12. In this case, only you can see a irregular verb, was. Next, did your parents give you anything special on your birthday? Was it nice? Good. Only you can see a regular verb. Very good. Next. Two, complete the sentences with the correct form of be. In this case, we have 3, 6 exercises to practice this. So, at 11 p.m. last night, Mark, in this case, Mark is third person. For third person, you need was in bed because it's last night. Next. B, where were you at 7 p.m. yesterday? Remember, where and was depend of the pronoun. If the pronoun is I, he, she, or it, you should use was. If the pronoun is you, we, or they, the verb to be is were. Okay? Next, letter D. I was at home last night because I was at my grandma's house. It was her birthday. Okay? Next, was Kevin at the party last Saturday? No, he wasn't. Very good. In the next exercise, we have look at the Rita's list of things to do yesterday. Write questions and answers. Okay, this is a list of Rita's list. And in this list, Rita has some activities. Okay, so, for example, send a text message to Sue, chat online with Mike, download a song, post a comment, write my blog. Okay, very good. Next. Did Rita send a text message to Sue? No, she didn't. Did Rita chat online with Mike? Yes, she did. Did Rita download a song? No, she didn't. Did Rita post a comment? No, she didn't. Did Rita write my blog? Yes, she did. In this case, is his blog, is her blog, so is her. Did Rita write her blog? Yes, she did. Okay, good. In the last exercise, we have complete the text with a simple password of the verbs in parentheses. The World Wide Web. 30 years ago, there wasn't or was not a World Wide Web, and there wasn't any social network sites. By 1994, there was about 100 important websites. Today, there are millions. The web developed when search engines such as Google became available and more people got high-speed broadband in their homes. Today, it is hard to imagine life without the web. Yeah, it's impossible, I think. Okay, so we have the parts of different verbs. Remember, it depends, in this case, of the pronoun. Okay, esto depende del pronombre, en el caso del pasado del verbo to be. Si tenemos el pronombre I, he, she, and it, usamos was. Y si tenemos el pronombre you, they, or we, usamos were. Okay? Very good. Hemos resuelto estos ejercicios y espero que ustedes puedan verificarlo en sus hojas de trabajo también. Your homework. What is your homework? Write about a past experience traveling to other city using the past simple or simple past. You include 50 words in your paragraph. Okay? Entonces, chicos, su tarea del día de hoy es escribir acerca de una experiencia pasada viajando a otra ciudad usando el pasado simple. Por favor, considerar 50 palabras. Cuídense mucho y nos vemos en la siguiente clase. Bye.